If my email address changes, how can I manually reset the device? If your email address changes, you can transfer the tool through our website. Just go to My Products, then My Device, and click Transfer. Now, if you've forgotten your password or no longer have access to your previous email, just reach out to our tech support team. Make sure you have a copy of your purchase receipt and a photo of your tool's serial number ready when you contact them. There's a 1-year free update period. After that year, if I don't renew, can I still use the software I've already downloaded? Also, what functions are available after that first year if I don't pay the subscription fee? If you decide not to renew, don't worry. You still have lifetime access to several core features like EOBD diagnostic software, IM readiness, performance test, DTC repair guide, technical service bulletins, DLC locations, the warning light library, and the VE calculator. So overall, you will keep a lot of the core functions of the tool. However, you will lose some functionality like bidirectional controls and service functions if you're not renewed for your subscription. If you're wondering about the subscription fee, the TopScan Lite is $59 and the TopScan Pro is $99. These fees cover access to updated vehicle software, maintenance function, and remember, if you choose to renew later, you'll only pay for the upcoming year. No need to worry about backdated chargers, so there's no welcome back fee. What should I do if the AutoVIN function says it can't parse the vehicle's VIN? First, let's make sure that your vehicle diagnostic software and firmware are up to date. If it's still not working after that, please upload the data and send us the device serial number along with the vehicle's VIN. We'll take it from there and analyze the issue for you. Can I change the unit measurement in the data stream interface, like switching from Celsius to Fahrenheit? At the moment, unit conversion in the data stream isn't available, but we're working on it for a future update, so stay tuned. Can you explain how TopScan handles data stream editing and 4-in-1 graphing display? With the TopScan, you can streamline your data by selecting only the points you want to view, which makes navigation a lot more efficient. You can also use a search function to filter specific data. Plus, you can display up to 4 graphs at once, so it's easier to observe and analyze data in real time. Why does TopScan show some systems as non-existent during a full vehicle scan? This can happen for a few reasons. First, different models under the same brand may share a diagnostic system. So if your vehicle doesn't have certain systems, they'll appear as unsupported. Also, higher trim vehicles often have more systems than lower trim vehicles. So those might show up as missing during the scan. There could also be communication issues with the vehicle's system that need to be repaired. And finally, if your firmware or diagnostic system isn't up to date, that could also cause this. If you're unsure, please upload a log, provide your device's serial number, and our support team will look into it for you. How should I handle diagnostics of Sprinter models compared to Mercedes-Benz? The Sprinter models have actually been separated from Mercedes-Benz lineup, so you'll need to go in to diagnose them under the Sprinter brand, not Mercedes-Benz. Just select Sprinter from the list and you'll be good to go. The supported chassis numbers include all of these listed. Can you explain the login free rules for CarPal and TopScan accounts? Typically, you'll stay logged in for 30 days. However, if you frequently switch between CarPal and TopScan apps, your session might expire sooner and you'll need to log in again